Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in the Cube. And as you know, Adam and I have been digging into the fabric. And one of the things that I've encountered is that I need to bring in Python libraries and modules that aren't automatically installed when I start working in the notebooks. And I ran across something that makes my life a little easier. And I want to show you. So you know how I like to do. Instead of all this talking, let's do what? Let's head over to my laptop. Let's say I'm working in Fabric and I've created this notebook and I found this library and there's lots of release versions of this particular one. And so I found it and I wanted to use it. And so let's go over to this particular notebook right here. What I had to do was I needed to install it. So a little error handling, I said, try to see if you can import this. If not, go ahead and install it. So you just need the URL to it and you can get that from this webpage. You see where it says download files. And so the first thing I need to do is run this script. So I can do this. And then once my session is started, what'll happen is that, wow, 3 seconds to start that session, it's gonna start running some stuff and then install everything. All this library helps me do is download some files from a web page. And so you can see it's importing it. Here's the URL that I wanna use. This is where I wanna output it. Really, really simple. So I go ahead and run this. Takes a few seconds to actually perform the download. And now when it's done, watch this. I'm gonna go here, click refresh, and then you'll see that file. So that's the file that I downloaded. If some time passes and that session stops, and I try to run that script without reinstalling the module again, what do you think will happen? Let me show you. So if you head over here, I'm gonna intentionally stop the session. So my session is stopped. And then I've already installed this. What I'm gonna do is go ahead and try to run this again. Just give it a few seconds to start my session up. Get a nice little error. And that's because when the session stopped, all of that install is gone and now I need to reinstall it again. You may be thinking, that's not very efficient. It's not, because if I want to schedule this notebook, I don't want to run that extra step every time. But guess what? The Microsoft team, they've come up with a way to make this so simple that if I think I'm going to reuse this over and over again, let's go over here. I have a different lake house that I'm working on. So it's called Rideshare and I'm going to get some data. So if you go over to workspace settings and go to data engineering, and you'll see library management. If you go right there and simply click add, it's telling you where it's getting it from. I'm gonna type wget. It recognizes it. It gives me all the versions out there. I want the latest one. I click apply. And then what'll happen is it takes probably about 2 minutes to get this all set up in the background. So I can leave here and it'll keep going. Now, let me show you. Let me go over to one that already has it. I'm gonna go to my Fabric Playground, go to workspace settings, go to data engineering, go to library management. And then what you'll see is that I already have it. And if I just, I have a notebook in here, somewhere in here, I have a notebook where I'm getting data right here from the web. So let's go to this notebook and I'm not gonna run any install or anything like that. The session stopped. I'm gonna go fire this up. This particular Spark session does take a little bit to start. Not quite sure why, but once it starts, it'll actually run and download that file in that directory without the requirement of installing that module every time I need to run it. And so now when I schedule my notebook to run, I can avoid that step. So you can see I completely got rid of that step up here and then it'll install it. So now you can see my session has started. It took about 34 seconds, still really fast compared to how it used to be. And now it's wrapping up the download of this file for me. And if I go here and click refresh, give it a second, you can see that it downloaded that file for me. All right, what do you think? Are you working or tinkering with the Microsoft Fabric? Have you learned some tips and tricks? Have you run into some challenges? Can this help you? I'd love to know. You know what to do. Post it in the comments below. If you want to learn more about the Microsoft Fabric, go ahead and check out that playlist that's flying above my head. And as always, from Adam and myself, thanks for watching. See you in the next video.